Okay.
Your Worship, the state and the defense have taken a very practical approach. We've agreed on a redacted version of the affidavit, Your Worship. We sat together and did the redactions together. The affidavit, which I'm going to hand up to the court, Your Worship, is the version that has been agreed to between the state and the defense, Your Worship. My colleague will confirm that, Your Worship.
Mr. Nkun.
To concur with the submission made by my learned colleague, Your Worship.
Must I then take it that the application to reopen, you're abandoning Mr. Ibrahim?
It's not Your Worship.
I see. Must I, Mr. Nkunu, take it that the supplementary affidavit together with the annexures to it, as well as the standalone document that is discover and add solutions for the world of travel, is agreed to?
Yes, sir.
Fine. The supplementary affidavit is exhibit, is admitted by court and marked as exhibit F. And the standalone document I earlier referred to is exhibit G.
On the issue the court wanted clarity on, there's a investigating officer's bail statement, or short bail statement, vaguely from the not a bail statement, just a statement on the aspect the court wanted the investigating officer to clarify, vaguely from the court to read same into the record.
Yes.
The court please. I saw a little one say I will state under oath in English that I am number 20244227, Sergeant of South African Police Service under Detective Branch District Soweto National SIPS. I'm the investigating officer of this case in which the passports were not verified due to Home Affairs personally authorized to verify the passport status and are currently on lockdown. We should by now understand the content of the statement. Of no objection to taking the preside oath, consider same to be binding on my said consciousness. The said statement was signed by the deponent and commission. Thank you for the court.
End objection, Mr. Ibrahim.
Exhibit H. I know Mr. Ibrahim has abandoned his application to reopen. Any such application from the state?
None.
Fine, now we then address this with respect to judgment now that we have the information as requested by the court. Mr. Ibrahim.
Sorry, Your Worship, I didn't get that.
Address. In judgment,
Your Worship, it's my humble submission, Your Worship, that the accused, Your Worship, together with her first affidavit and her supplementary affidavit and the annexes thereto, Your Worship, has made out a sufficient case, Your Worship, that she be considered a suitable candidate for bail, that she has satisfied all of the conditions as set out in the relevant sections, Your Worship, and that, Your Worship, she is indeed, Your Worship, not a flight risk. That she will abide by any conditions that this Honorable Court seeks to impose, and Your Worship, that the proper functioning of the criminal justice system will not in any way be undermined by releasing her on bail. Your Worship, I'm going to keep it brief because I think I've dealt with most of it in the affidavit. I do, however, wish to confirm, Your Worship, that based on the accused circumstances and due to the current COVID-19 lockdown, and the shutdown of the travel industry, Your Worship, the accused has raised an amount of 10,000 rands for bail. That amount, Your Worship, has been made available by family members. And, Your Worship, the accused will abide by any further conditions this Honorable Court seeks to impose, as the Court pleases, Your Worship.
I'll start by referring this court to one saying that was quoted in one case. It's a case of Pika Msikili versus the state. It's a case that was adjudicated in the High Court in Free State, Bloemfontein. Unfortunately, I don't have a full citation, but it's a case that was, the judgment was passed on the 12th of May 2017. It was not a formal bail application per se, but it was a case of an accused that was playing hide and seek. Matter was set down for a trial in a couple of times, Worship. It was given numerous dates. Accused failed to appear in court, even after granted bail, Worship. The magistrate in that matter issued the warrant of arrest, held it over, and also did a provisional forfeiture of the accused's bail money. In that case, what transpired is that accused at all time indicated that he was sick and was kept at the hospital, and he will go to the doctors every time when he has to appear in court, obtain a medical certificate, or call the investigating officer, indicate that he's currently at the hospital. So every time when the trial needed to start, the accused will always be sick or admitted at the hospital. Even doctors came and testified, some of them. The judge in that case eventually wanted all doctors to come to court and testify and give the court a report ever since they started examining the said accused, Worship. Eventually, the judge in that case authorized a warrant of arrest and forfeited the bail man of the accused. Accused paid bail in the amount of 100,000 rand, Worship, in that case. He appealed to the High Court, and then eventually they found in favor they upheld the decision of the magistrate, Worship. That indeed accused was playing hide and seek. The reason why I'm citing such a case It's because even in this case, the defense captain say, at all these material times, we're willing to hand ourselves over to the investigating officer. There's Riaz involved calling the investigating officer to make arrangement for the accused to hand herself over to the investigating officer. In the first affidavit, they even say, I contacted my lawyer because I wanted to hand myself over to the investigating officer so that I can appear in court. On the date of when the applicant was arrested, they say again, I even contacted Mr. Kara when these people were there to effect arrest. Based on this, on all these three scenarios, I keep saying I contact this person because I want to hand myself off. I contact the investigating officer, I want to hand myself off. But she never handed herself over. As we stand now, we know the applicant never handed herself off. She hid herself and she was arrested. Looking at the conduct of the accused or applicant in this case, can we really say this is a person that if we grant a bail, is going to come back to court and attend this trial? Clearly not. Because if she had wanted to make sure that she clears her name in court, she would have handed herself long time ago. There were people that could have assisted her. No reason is profiled why she did not. She merely says as a getaway card because of lockdown. Lockdown did not say don't go to the police station and hand yourself over to the police officers who are looking for you. Or contact the investigating officer so that you can come make arrangement with the investigating officer so that you can appear at the police station and be arrested. It did not say that. For her to use that as an excuse, Yoshu, the state will submit that it lacks merit, Yoshu. I'll further refer to the very same case, Yoshu. There was a principle that was or saying the judge relied at in that case, in paragraph 35, where it says, where the eggs in the basket on the left are not the same as the eggs in the basket on the right, the chickens will never be the same. Let's look at these two affidavits. There's a supplementary affidavit. There's an affidavit that was handed in previously. The one that we have makes mention of three passports. The first one makes mention of two. The one that we have makes mention of Reyes, but went even to the investigating officer and make arrangement for the applicant to be handed in. In the first affidavit, she says she did not even know who the investigating officer was. In this affidavit we are dealing with, she says, I know who the investigating officer was. I even called the investigating officer when I was in KZN to indicate that I'm in KZN seeking medical assistance. These are two conflicting versions. In this affidavit, you're saying you don't know the investigating officer. This one, you're saying you know the investigating officer. Clearly, this is a person that is not taking the court into her confidence. She's proffering before court versions that are conflicting in nature. And she's not giving a satisfactory explanation as to why these versions are conflicting. This on the face very clearly shows, and it purports to show that the applicant is an untrustworthy person. Even looking at the offense that she's currently facing, we release her on bail. Chances that we'll never see the said plaintiff again attending this court. Justice will never be done in this case, Osho. One might be tempted and say, why didn't she flee and go to other places? The very same case I refer the court to. Fleeing is described in various ways. You fleeing does not mean that you have to go to Canada, USA, or abroad. You fleeing can flee in the very same jurisdiction where you're supposed to appear. Like this, like the matter referred to the accused in that case. Every time when he was supposed to go to court, he'll go to a doctor and not come to court. But clearly, that's a person that was not interested in seeing that justice is not only done, but is seen to be done. Even in this case, she evaded the law.
The state will submit that looking at the fact that clearly there is evidence that shows that there's a likelihood that if accused or applicant is granted bail, he will never come back to stand trial in this matter. She will attempt to flee or play hide and seek game as she did with the investigating officer. Because if she can do it to the investigating officer, what is stopping her from doing it to the court? We've seen on numerous occasions accused when we give them bail, they don't come to court. We'll have to bring them to court through a warrant of arrest. The state will submit. Clearly, accused is a flight risk in this case. There's a likelihood that accused or applicant do not attend trial. Now, there's another issue of saying defense are trying to make payments or accused attempted to make payments to the victims in this case. That's on its own. Number one, portrays consciousness of guilt. Number two, it shows intimidation and interference with witnesses. Clearly, she's the kind of person willing to say today she's going to interfere with witnesses. Say, I'm going to pay you this amount of money. Don't go to court and testify. Or don't proceed with the case. Let's accurately define what is interference with witnesses. Just going to do that. Intimidation in reverse. I'm going to withhold paying you money if you proceed with the case. You withdraw the case, you're going to get your money back. That's intimidating or interference with the witnesses. Clearly, there's a likelihood we'll release her on bail today. She's going to interfere with the investigation as well as the witnesses in this case. Other aspect, Osho, is this issue of saying, In this affidavit, as well as the other affidavit, it does appear on both affidavits. She intends to pay the victims. However, they are not telling the court, where is this money going to come from? Is there an account there with this man? Do they have an offshore account where they will get this money from? Even for the purpose of bail, they're saying it's family members that is going to pay this man for bail. Clearly, the state will repeat this. Applicant is not playing open hands or open card with the state as well as the court. There's information that she's deliberately withholding and not disclosing to this court. Specifically to her assets. What assets does she have? She continued to confine herself to these assets that amount to 300,000. And she felt it does not indicate how she reached that amount of 300,000. Because that appears on the first affidavit as well. The state will submit, lastly, that the accused is failing to take the court into her own confidence. Number two, accuses a flight risk. Number three, accused will interfere with witnesses if granted bail, and bail should be refused. No further submission by the state.
Reply, Ms. Eban.
Your Worship, I'm only going to touch on the aspects raised by my colleague. Your Worship, we'll start with the most pertinent one, which is the investigating officer. Your Worship, the state is quick, Your Worship, to refer to Riaz, Your Worship, refer to arrangements made to surrender the accused. However, Your Worship, what the state has not given any explanation before this court, and it's not been rebutted, is that arrangements were made. And the first time the court has been made aware of such arrangements has been today. Your Worship, the investigating officer has taken the time to search for the accused for 6 months, as he has put it, and confirmed in the witness box. He's taken the time to give my colleague an affidavit which was ready into the record today. But he, however, Your Worship, has not taken the time to take the court into his confidence and detail in his affidavit the fact that arrangements were made to surrender the accused. And he doesn't even venture to give an explanation as to why he doesn't mention that. And why, for the first time today, we hear that the accused made an arrangement. It's not disputed, Your Worship. The state has not rebutted it. The state has conceded to the fact that arrangements were made to surrender the accused.
Now, Your Worship, the fact that arrangements were made and that the COVID-19 lockdown happened, that in itself, Your Worship, is not a justification for the state to make the quantum leap to her evading her trial. Now, the state ventures the following argument, that one can evade the trial in your own jurisdiction. Your Worship, that can be clearly handled in a very simple way by attaching bail conditions. The accused can report into a police station every day and sign in, Your Worship. The accused can report into a police station twice a day and sign in, Your Worship. So that argument of fear from the state is not a real fear, Your Worship, and is not in itself a reason for the accused to be denied bail. Now, Your Worship, my colleague refers to so-called refunds that have to be made to the complainants and intimidation in reverse by withholding a refund until you withdraw the case. Your Worship, what my colleague is not taking the court into confidence on is the fact that the complainants are approaching the family of the accused and asking for refunds, of which he is aware. Mr. Mahit has been in court on every single occasion except for the last two occasions. So how can it be said that it's intimidation in reverse? The accused has stated her intention. She intends to repay the complainant. But how does she do that while she's in custody? So what specifics would my colleague like us to present before the court as to how she's going to make this possible? She's not working. She's incarcerated at this point in time. Your Worship, regarding her having offshore accounts, it's a quantum leap, Your Worship. We can expect, Your Worship, that the National Party will take control of this country again, Your Worship, because that's as big a quantum leap as my colleague is making. Offshore accounts, there's no basis for the assumption. There's no information that is given as to why he suspects offshore accounts. And in fact, what's more, even more pertinent, is he hasn't even detailed to his court what attempts he has made or his investigating officer has made to detail what assets are in the accused possession or owned by her. In fact, there is nothing to rebut what the accused has put on her two affidavits. The so-called 300,000 rands in assets that the accused has stated is her assets. What other assets must she put down? 300,000 rands worth of assets, Your Worship, is not insubstantial. It's a substantial amount of assets on anyone's balance sheet. Your Worship, we have already explained in both the affidavits that we are relying and really holding out hope that refunds will be forthcoming from the Kingdom of Saudi. It is there. We have stated that from the beginning of the matter. In fact, the contentious letter by Mr. Mia also states it. So it's no secret as to how we intend to repay the complainants. But that in itself, Your Worship, should not be a reason to refuse her bail. She's done everything in her power to convince this court. All of the information that has been placed before this court, there's nothing to suggest that she's not a suitable candidate for bail. If anything, Your Worship, the suggestion and inference can be drawn that the investigating officer has not been forthright and truthful to this court. He was here today as well, Your Worship, and he still hasn't rebutted the allegations that were made and raised. He is not, for the first time, he's acknowledged that yes, in fact, he has met Riaz. Why did he not say that before, Your Worship? Why has he not put that in his affidavit? This matter's been dragging on from March in respect of this bail application. He and the prosecutor and the complainants have had more than ample time to consult. So one surely would think that a fact as important as meeting Riaz at the police station and arranging to surrender the accused would be something he would remember and put into his affidavit. But he doesn't. Your Worship, it's unfortunate. My colleague is in the unfortunate position because he's in the hands of the IOM. He's confined to his statement. But the fact of the matter is, and from the facts on affidavit from the investigating officer and the accused and the concessions made, the only inference is that the investigating officer has not been forthright with this court. Your Worship, in respect of the so-called, I just want to touch on one more aspect regarding this reverse intimidation. It is the accused's intention, and it is stated in her affidavits. It's stated amply in her affidavits that she intends to refund all of the complainants, that she relies on the refunds coming from the Kingdom of Saudi. She's demonstrated that she has paid these monies across the kingdom of Saudi, and she's therefore reliant in order to make these refunds possible. And that is still her intention. Now, her intention to refund the complainants can never be deemed to be reverse intimidation. In fact, it's the right thing to do. And she's indicated that from the outset. She hasn't run from her obligations and said, I'm assuming or availing myself of the right to remain silent, and therefore I am not going to place any facts before this honorable court until the copies of the docket have been made available to me. She doesn't say that. She's come on record and she's presented a version at the outset, although not required to do so. And that, Your Worship, there can be no other inference that her intentions are good. She resides within the region of Lanesia. She's 62 years old. She has underlying medical conditions. The country and the globe in general is going through a pandemic of a nature we have never seen before. She is a suitable candidate. She's not a violent offender. Neither is she a repeat offender. All of these cases stem from the same incident. Now, the case that my colleague refers to regarding the individual that was out on bail, that kept evading his trial by not arriving at court, can never be compared to this instance, Your Worship. It can never be, on any stretch of the imagination, be compared. That the circumstances are completely different. The accused was out on bail, and on every occasion he had to arrive in court, there was an excuse for him not to arrive in court. This accused has never been out on bail. She is applying for bail. She's presumed innocent until she's found guilty. She has a right to remain silent, but she has stated the facts of her defense to this honorable court. So the two cases can never be likened to each other. There are more than 10 members of the accused family that are in the gallery, that have been in the gallery ever since this case has started. It is an indication of the close familial ties that the accused has with this community and with her own family. She holds no foreign passport. She holds, although not specifically stated in the affidavit, she stated her assets, but I'm stating my instructions are she holds no assets overseas. She has no foreign passport. She doesn't hold any dual nationality, and she has no intention of leaving the Republic of South Africa. She's a suitable candidate to be considered for bail, and the state has advanced no rational argument. That is not a generalized cut and paste argument from a previous bail application as to why this accused should not get bail. She's advanced reasons why she should be considered a suitable candidate for bail. She's indicated that she will abide by any conditions this court seeks to impose, and the court has a discretion on the kind of conditions it needs to impose. As I said, Your Worship, the court could impose the conditions that she reports into the police station once a week. She can report into the police station every day of the week. In fact, she can report into the police station twice a day, every day of the week. That would, in essence, take care of the state's concerns regarding that. Further conditions can be added to her bail conditions, Your Worship. She can be instructed not to leave the region of Lanesia without the investigating officer's written permission. She can be confined to house arrest during certain hours without the investigating officer's permission not to leave and to continue to reside. She can be requested not to apply for any travel documents, which she has undertaken to do so already. So all of those circumstances that the state has raised, Your Worship, can be catered for with the appropriate bail conditions, can be catered for with the appropriate bail amount. And the investigating officer, Your Worship, is, in my opinion, a competent person, be that he's a stranger, it appears to the truth, but he seems to be pretty confident. And it seems to be pretty capable of ensuring that the accused sticks to the bail conditions imposed by this honorable court, him together with his station commander. So, Your Worship, I have no reason to doubt, and I submit that the accused has made out a fair case to be released on bail, and that she ought to be considered a suitable candidate for bail, as the court pleases, Your Worship.
Can I have the court book, please? Thank you.
Fine, the applicant must stand up. Now, due to the time factor and the heavy court roll, judgment in this matter is reserved until Friday, 8th May 2020, Pagan Regional Court, Tulinesia at 8:30, which is remanded in custody without bail currently. However, she is to be kept at the hospital section of prison.
To our attention regarding Johannesburg Prison.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, Your Worship, they have their own internal regulation that has now come into being, and that unless the detention warrant specifically states that the accused must be brought to court for a bail application, they're not bringing the accused to court.
Yes.
So apparently, you've got to physically, the captain in charge of the prisoner collection has to physically see an endorsement on the detention warrant that says accused to be brought to court for bail application. That's the latest that we got today, Your Worship.
That's the practice with the detention warrants.
That's my understanding as well, Your Worship.
Yes,
Your Worship.
Yes, Your Worship. That's the practice.
Thank you.
Okay. Can I then have the detention warrant? Okay, I've written on the detention warrant that the accused has to be kept at the hospital section of prison due to her state of health, and also that she has to be in court for bail application on the 8th May 2020. Yeah, thank you.
Sir,